really strong as they took down Toxic Youth. Evil Genius and this team are doing their first picks and bans, so we're just gonna see what's gonna happen. I'm just gonna go right into that right now. Just give me a second, guys. Sorry, I'm a bit slow. Spacing out as standard. Going right into this now, and they've done a bit of a little slow, but the first ban of Evil Genius was Feral, and the first ban of Nafig from the beach was the Affliction Warlock. So EG picks up the Feral Druid, as it's gonna be free yips, and Nafig from the beach picks up the Elemental Shaman. So gonna be interesting as EG is gonna ban the okay, sorry, my voice. EG is gonna ban the Affliction Warlock second, and Nafig from the beach is gonna ban the Shadow Priest, as they want to deny the FPS, which is kind of strong team. So we're gonna see Sidhu on the Holy Priest, which I've never seen before, but this is gonna be interesting. Yes, Sidhu on the Holy Priest, he's probably been playing everything, and I'm waiting to see a Blast Badar. It's gonna be Feral, Priest, Ali. That's probably one of the it's probably the strongest comp in the game, actually. Holy Priest, Feral, they're gonna be able to play the best comp in the game, and I don't think this is really good picks and bans for Nafig from the beach, to be honest. Like, banning Affliction and Shadow, these are, like, not the most OP classes. I would probably ban Ellie or Feral first. I would probably ban Feral. If they pick Ellie, I'll ban Locke or something like that, so they don't have something that synergizes too good, at least. But you're just gonna be always be able to play something really good for the team, but still, banning not either the Ellie or the Feral is just gonna be a huge mistake, I think. But Nafig from the beach is gonna be able to play Ellie, Mage, Disc Priest as well. It's a decent comp, but I'm pretty sure Evil Genesis should be able to pick this one easily after playing the by far more superior comp. So this is gonna be huge. They're playing the best comp in the game, and I don't think Nafig from the beach should ever let them play this. But so this is gonna be Feral, Holy Priest, Elemental versus Mage, Elemental, Disc Priest. So I think also Nafig from the if Nafig from the beach does a good job killing off the Light Well of the Holy Priest, they might be in a little bit trouble. But you're seeing Blast Badar with Yips and CDU, so it's gonna be some of the stronger teams in Europe. So yeah, I don't think Nafig from the beach can take this one if they don't have something super good. Release the Yips. Yeah, I think we're releasing the Yips now, guys. Have Yips actually played one game? I don't think so. I don't think Yips has played a single game. So, we're just gonna see what's gonna happen here. As we're gonna see EG versus Nafig from the beach. So, that's gonna be interesting. If you wanna hit me on Twitter, ask me, tell me predictions or anything like that. You can hit me on RylezWow on Twitter. Ask me anything nice. Kind of appropriate to say on stream. I will probably read it out loud, anything like that. So we're just about to go in, guys, into the first best of three series, second game of the day, Evil Geniuses versus Nafig from the beach, USA versus Russia, Mother Russia, Vodka, land of drunken people. Yep, this is awkward. Yeah, that this is awkward, guys. Gonna have a little bit chill music in the background, I guess. Might be nice, you know. Try to just test out something. Having some music in the background, everything like that. So thank you. Welcome back.
Hey.
So, you set up picks and mats?
Let me just get them up. Why is it not loading?
It's gonna be elemental. The team EG is gonna be playing elemental, elemental feral holy priest, which is probably one of the best comps in the game right now. And Nafig from the Beach is gonna playing elemental mage disc priest. So team EG is in a huge advantage, I think. Also, with Apparat, try to just put his nameplate as Phenomenon. That's his actual name. Yeah, you know, mage is fake you, and I'm gonna find out the elemental's name. The elemental's name is Kallak, so it is Kallak on elemental.
Okay, so yeah, with Cedu is obviously on Disc Priest, and I think that's actually his weakest healer, but I think he's been
doesn't
practicing
matter.
A lot.
It's so easy to play. I played Holy Priest one day, and trust me, it doesn't matter. Like, he might be good, like, he's probably not on Soda level or something like that, but you can easily be, like, if you're a top player and you roll on Holy Priest, you're gonna be easily, like, rank 1 material. You're gonna easily be good enough.
Yeah, I think he's also been practicing it a lot recently, because obviously he might have needed to run it in the tournament. And yeah. I think with the comp they're running, they're just gonna be in such a good advanced position. I think it's Yips on Feral, so he's obviously really good on Feral.
Yeah, so we're seeing probably one of the stronger teams here. Compositions in the game coming out for the first time, I think. I don't think we have seen LE. Yeah, I think both of them run this comp actually, so kind of coping, but it is one of the stronger team in comps in the game. Understandable. As they pick that, might just die. It's gonna be Talbadar. So the countdown has begun. 20 seconds from now, we're gonna be able to go into the first best of three of the second game here. EG versus Nafig from the Beach. Start spamming the chat, guys. EG, 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 USA. Are they gonna be able to take it home for America? We're gonna see now. In 5 seconds, toggling Blizz UI, hiding my character and everything. We're gonna go in here. We're gonna see what's gonna happen here. So. Looks like Talbot just trying to get some lava burst, trying to get some early pressure, you know, going out, getting some little bit of pressure, breaking his shells, everything like that. And looks like CD going for the. He's playing with that feather, so he's gonna be able to do a lot of feathers and give him teams a lot of speed, actually.
Yeah, that's gonna give them a lot of chasing potential as well as disengage as well when they need it. Right now, though, Phenomenon is pushed in. It did get put into a root there, has got PI available. CD put into a full sheep, though, deep onto Yips. It looks like he's going to be the target. Not in too much trouble right now, though. Flame shocks are spread out across everyone right now. Hex onto Kallak does get dispelled by Fake You. Fake You going to be the target right now. Yips looking to collect onto him quite hard, but Yips in quite a bit of trouble. Dipped about half. Cedu does pick him up quite nicely. Cedu does get put into a blanket counterspell there. Yips down to about three quarters right now, but force the ice block of Fake You with a clone onto Phenomenon.
Yeah, and also a lot of lava bursts into Fake You, and I think some we crit there as well, guys. He's back down from 100%. Probably in 1 second. See, Yip's actually taking a lot of pressure. Each time he goes offensive, he's actually gonna spike down. He spiked down actually to 30% HP. It's kind of scary, and he didn't use anything. The Cedu gets blank cessed, I think. I don't think he got locked out. And I also think Nafig from the Beach should be trying to kill the Light Orb, but Yip's spiking down again, and he's gonna get healed off with the instant heals from Cedu. But wow, these one-shots on Yips are scary. If I was Cedu, I mean, I would be really scared of healing Yips. Same with Yips, I would be really scared to go out there. So, yeah, what is your time going to play?
Faku's pet did seem to be the target there, but what if they can use on a fear by Seedu there, as they are pushing in. Faku's pet dropped to about half right now. Still got Flame Shock, so they're going to use that for extra procs. Faku down to about 40% right now, though. It's going to be the main target. Does get a kick onto Phenomenon, though, on his pennant, so great play by Yips there. Faku taking a huge amount of damage as Phenomenon will need to pick him up. It's starting to cast the heals now, though, but looks like Faku's going to be fine for the time being. In the meantime, though, Team EG aren't under too much pressure at the moment. A little bit of damage onto Talbadar, though. Full sheep onto Seedu, and this could be it for Talbadar. He does have to use Healing Tide here just to try and get through this, but Yips was put into a full fear and was into a really bad spot. Both sat about 70% right now. It's Thunderstorm back out there. Going to use the Pillar to line of sight, put some rejuves up, and just help Seedu out a little bit.
Yeah, and to be honest, it doesn't look like they're going to be in trouble, even though Seedu's siding so much CC. I mean, you're still playing with players holding hands. I mean, you have a Feral Druid, he can off-heal, he kind of has Heart of the Wild, and Talbadar just off-healing as well.
Music off.
So they're gonna be fine, you know, with having all this stuff, even though if Seedu can sit a lot of CC, but look at Kallak just dropping to 20% HP, and he has to catch PS there. He gets catched up, he's using Healing Tide, and I think they're overlapping a little bit too much here, using Healing Tide, NS, and yeah, a lot of stuff there, but look at Yips, they're spiking down to 30% HP. Seedu hacks to Twinkie there to catch him up here, and nice job, but the Deep Freeze catches in a little bit too late. Heart of Wild has been popped there by Yips, kind of overlapped, but he looks like actually still in a lot of trouble here. Trying to run back here, but look at Kallak again, taking so much trouble. Talbadar doing as well, taking a little bit of pressure himself, so catching back and forth with these elementals one-shotting, with Yips spiking down all the time. It's so crazy watching these elementals one-shotting each other all the time. Yeah, and Talbadar again spiking down again. This is so crazy watching elementals just bursting each other down every one in second.
There's a deep on the Yips here, though, with a blanket on Seedu. Yips in a lot of trouble, down to about 20%. Needs a lot of help right now. Does get picked up pretty much into full there. But Seedu just pulling back a little bit along with Talbadar. Looks like they're going to be targeting Kallak right now. Faku able to free cast for the time being. Does get sheared on Frost, but full Cyclone onto Phenomenon. So, well, with a fear onto Faku that does get tremored out of. Faku does put a polymorph out, but looks like that was grounded by Talbadar. So Faku just looking to try and heal for his team right now. Full kick onto Phenomenon though on his cast, so Kallak has to heal himself. Hex onto Faku is instantly dispelled by Kallak, so he's set about 40%. Saurian onto Phenomenon though. Full sheep onto Seedu here. Looks like they might be turning around this one. Yep, it's full Deep Freeze onto him. He did trinket that, and grounding comes down as well as he's got the light well while Seedu's in that sheep. Seedu then put into a half sheep off that, and Talbadar just doing a great job peeling Thunderstorm into interrupt cast, but looks like Faku's in quite a vulnerable position right now. If they swap on him, it could be good, but looks like they're just wanting to push in on Kallak right now. Yips behind the pillar, does get Thunderstormed away. Seedu there as well, though. He's put into a Nova outside of line of sight of Yips. Yips has to NS himself with a Berserk up right now. Looks like they really want to get a lot of pressure here. They need some CC onto Phenomenon. There's the Chastise into a Fear, which he does have to Will of the Forsaken. Grounding Totem down. Full fear on Seedu though, this could be a lot of trouble for Yips. Does get tremored out of that. Yips still in a bit of trouble, has to get picked up. Full sheep onto Talbadar right now though.
Yeah, there's a blanket onto Seedu as well. And the Yips is taking so much pressure that still, and he's on 100% HP, he doesn't have Boxing available, he has to use his Bear Urshock, so he's gonna be taking a bit heal, get healed up a little bit by that, but he's still in a lot of trouble. I mean, Seedu doesn't have Trinket available. Talbot doesn't have Tremors available, so Seedu's gonna be stuck in a full fear right now. Nice job by Phenomenon actually running in for that fear and getting it full. Are they gonna be able to follow up that CC? They need to follow up the CC on Seedu, that's when they can do something. But Yip's still taking a lot of pressure, but no CC on Seedu, so he's gonna be able to catch him up, as he's gonna be able to do right now. So
Yip's in a full deep though, no catform available for that. Does have to disperse that with the half sheep and the fear on Seedu though, with a blanket on Talbadar as well. Doing a great job cross CCing, so neither able to help with Seedu put into a half sheet. Now Yip's in a little bit of trouble. Frozen off has just faded. Looks like he's going to be alright for the time being. Doing a great job kiting while Seedu's not been able to play. But might not be enough. Down to about 40% right now. Gets picked up. But at the same time, Talbadar's put into a full sheet while Phenomenon's mana's not doing too healthy. He's about half. While Seedu's about 75%. Full fear onto him though right now. With Yip's does use his NS to get a Cyclone there. Hex onto Faku. Kallak could be in a lot of trouble right now. He's isolated from his team. He has got Sham Rage up right now and Healing Tide. Might be okay, but he gets Thunderstormed into the starting room. Apparat, Phenomenon, miles away from him, does get gripped away and looks like he's going to be okay for the time being. Does pop a Fear Ward, so Seedu can't fear him just yet. Talbadar and Yips getting put into a Fear there with the Ring of Frost down. Looks like they're going to be fine, and Faku did Trinket there, as well as Phenomenon using Aura Mastery to get some Spirit Shell up.
Yeah, and I mean, when actually they forced Kallak to use everything like there, Seedu did a real nice chassis in the sea. Phenomena at the same time. But look at Faker at the moment. He's taking some serious pressure in the middle of the arena. Take a little bit ballsy, but he's going to be fine for now as Phenomena is not stuck in NCC. Faking at Shocker, casting, getting the Frost Balls off here on Yips. So no CC in CDU, but Yips taking still so much pressure. CDU is actually struggling keeping up, and Yips doesn't have this person available. He got a trinket right back up now. But look at Talbadar. He's pushing way too far, I think. Or not. But Yips is actually running in there. CDU is way far ahead, behind. I mean, so he's running with the Spectral guys, trying to get the, maybe a chassis into fair on Phenomenon. I don't know.
Does get pinned into a blanket, though, as Yips has to line of sight. Ring of Frost coming down, though, is going to pin Yips in there. Does run through it so he can get dispelled, but no dispel from CDU just yet. Talbadar in a lot of trouble right now. Drops to about 10%. Is forced to have CDU come and pick him up. Shamrage as well. Full sheep on CDU, though. Might just die here is his name, which is actually perfect because that's the situation he's in, but looks like he's going to be fine as he runs around the pillar to heal himself. Yip's in trouble now, though. He's using the Lightwell and rejuves on himself to keep himself up while CD comes out of CC and picks his team up.
Yeah, and Faker's taking a little bit of pressure here, but this is going to be fine. He's just going to go on LOS for Talbadar, and he's going to actually catch the PS right before the Cyclone. Nice job by Phenomenon, but he actually still have to Ice Block anyway. Wow, so much pressure coming in from Talbadar, even though, I mean, he catched the early PS there.
CDU pins to a deep, though. Yips could be in trouble if they can follow that up, but no CC available off that by the looks of it right now. CDU was in quite a vulnerable spot right there, but they didn't really take advantage of that. Yips just being ping-ponged around the map right now. Blaster Badar just in the middle of the map, looking like he's going to be trying to kite back as he's CDU needs to pick his team up, but Fake You and Phenomenon not doing too healthy on mana just because he's playing so aggressive. He's down to 70k, might need to look for a drink soon as CDU is still sat about 45% here, so not if they can keep this up, then EG are definitely going to be taking this. Yips still pushing in onto Fake You right now, even though he's under a lot of pressure. Fake You has got his own new shrink up, so he might look to set something up here. Does blink behind the pillar. Yips just trying to line of sight some of this damage. It's caught in a deep freeze with no cat former. Might drop down to 50k, might just die. Does get a dispersion and Mighty Vessel and Guardian Spirit here. So many cooldowns overlapped by EG there. Punish them later, but Fake You still going to be the target. Phenomenon down to 40k mana right now, gets stunned on that heal by a tree, and Pedance comes out. Did have Spirit Shell up there, but Fake You have run out now. Fake You does Will of the Forsaken there, and CD is put into a full fear, but it does get tremored.
Yeah, and actually I think one more chance is in the CD, like a deep blank CS is enough. Just wait till Orb is back up on CD, and I think they should just deep freeze and blank CS, but Faker might just die before that. He has to Ice Block here on 90% HP, but look
cancels
at the episode
to try and kill CD.
Yeah. And there's a full pump sheep mana into CDU and deep freeze here. Do they have the pressure here to kill him through Barskin here? He drops to 20% HP. There's going to be a life stop right before his CS, and that's so unfortunate for Nafig from the beach that it happened, because I'm pretty sure they would land a kill there, but it doesn't happen. So we're still in the game. It's like 1.5 minutes away from draw, by the way. So he's Faker just going for getting a new water mantle, and Yip's taking so much pressure. He doesn't have Barskin available. Nothing is available right now. No life stop, no trinket, nothing. CDU has a favorite on himself. He's catching a PI, but
Yip's
he's
bullshit,
and Yip's 4% HP is going to go down here. He's actually behind the pillar. Tranquility, they need to get there. They need to stop that. They need to finish him up. Blank says on him, and I don't think it is the right choice. He's on 5% HP, and he's just going to go down. What a nice game by Nathan from the beach. What a nice game.
Yeah, I think they knew it was about to time out, and Guardian Spirit and Disperse and Mighty Versa had all been used by them at the same time. And so that was a great punishment for that overlap of cooldowns by EG and that simple miscommunication.
Yeah, I mean, this team might take away EG's clean record here, the 100% win ratio, so don't think we might see it. I mean, as Talbadar is tryharding into not get it, maybe he can get that one shot here. Talbadar known for being a tryhard.
Probably not going to be able to get something, though. But yes, don't have a 100% win ratio. They have lost one series.
Well, I mean, the overall series. They haven't lost any overall series.
Yeah, they have. At 8-1.
They haven't. Not even.
Have they not?
No, like, an overall series is winning, basically losing two games in a one one team.
I thought they had.
No, they haven't.
Okay.
They haven't. So they basically have a clean record. Like, you can lose one game in a best of three series, but you can still win the overall series. You can still win two games and lose one series, if you know what I mean. EG can still lose this, like 2-0, and Nafig from the beach can get 1 point, but you can still win the next two series, and they'll get max point, and they're still liking a clean record. But still, I think Nafig from the beach did such a good job playing that FMP. So
yeah, I mean, I think it was really that miscommunication on the Disperse, Guardian Spirit, and Might of Ursoc from Yips and Seedu, though. Because if they'd had one of those cooldowns for the very end there, they could have survived and it'd have drawn out.
Yeah, I mean, they could have, but as well, I mean, Faku, they have Nafig from the beach, we're just forcing CDs after CDs. I mean, EG was doing some stuff, but it wasn't really a kill potential. I mean, they were forcing one ice block here and there, but Faku always had an ice block available, and he used it in the right time, so it didn't look like they had too much going on. Like, the CC on Phenomena was kind of poor as well. Like, they didn't even have a fair tremor, and there was not too many fears in him. And I feel like they should get a Cyclone or a Bash into fair. They should have way more CC into Phenomena. I mean, I played against a lot of good players playing that comp. They're playing right. EG's playing right now. And to be honest, you need a really strong team to beat that if they actually play good enough. But I don't feel like they played that well. Then that's just my guess. No, not too much CC into one
target.
I'd like
to see them putting more focus onto the Ellie Shaman on the other team, though. I really feel like because of the Major's Ice Blocks, as well as Pain Suppression from the Priest and the Priest cooldowns, I really feel like the Ellie Shaman's the better target. Because even though they'll Sham Rage on a minute cooldown, rather than having that one big cooldown to shut down all that pressure, he's definitely going to have... he has no real big cooldown. So once he has Sham Rage down, then it's his Trinket on a stun, his, you know, whatever, his Healing Tide, and then he hasn't really got anything.
Yeah, I mean, I think so too. I think also what they should try to look for is doing cross CC. Like, if they cross CC, for example, I mean, if they just coordinate some CC, like a Bash into Phenomenon, and then, I don't know, actually Bash into the Elemental, and the Kallak, and then they should just get at this, I can't even speak now, Chastise on the Phenomenon into a Fear, and then bash the Elemental at the same time. So that's what they should try to just get more CC, a clone after that. They should try to hex the mage, for example, when they actually stun the Elemental. They should try to do some CC. Like, they almost did no CC into Phenomenon, and without CC, you're not gonna kill. Phenomenon was playing even offensive that game.
Yips did a great job using his Treants in Swap Casts, but it's the fact that, like, priests have such strong healing, even without casting. That's the problem they're having right now, I feel.
Yeah, I think so too.
So we're just going to get killed off, and then we're going to get this game underway. So Team EG have chosen Dalaran this time, which is an interesting choice, because it is going to mean that Faku is going to be able to get a lot of Ring of Frost that are going to cover pretty much where the entire team is going to be. For instance, if CD's pushing him for Fears, then Faku is going to be able to put down a Ring of Frost, and he's either going to have to walk through it or try and walk around it and catch them in a Fear, and that's just going to slow his Fears down so much. So it's an interesting choice for EG here, but they might have Typhoon to knock back. But we are going to get this countdown started.
Yeah, and it's going to be a match point in the first best of three series for Nafig on the beach, so we're going to see if they're going to be able to take it, and they can even, like, turtle it out and get a draw, which, yeah, many teams might be able to abuse, you know. 11-minute mark, you can easily survive that if you play well defensively, so we're going to see what's going to happen here. As we're about to go into countdown here, 10 seconds left here. Just going to start the countdown on the Toggle Blitz UI when it's 4 seconds. So, games are going in, and we're gonna see if Team EG is gonna make a comeback in this first best of three series here. Are they gonna be able to get some more CC into Phenomenon? Because that's what I want to see. I want to see them actually get some really huge chain CC into him and finish off either Kallak or Faku, to be honest. They managed to force ice blocks and stuff like that, just getting random bursts, but they need the CC as well to get the ideal execute.
That was a good Ring of Frost from Faku, though. He did actually force Seedu to stay in that, and he did catch Yips in that. So Tabadar took a lot of damage there for no real reason. Yips going out. Looks like Kallak is going to be his target. Does fake the kick, so Yips could be in some trouble here. If we see a Deep Freeze Blanket come out, full sheep on Seedu, actually. That's going to be so much better. But Yips does go Bark Skin, and he is going to kite away. Looks like he's going to rejuve himself. Seedu put into a half sheep off that. It looks like Yips is going to be fine there. So they switch over onto Tabadar, who's put into a Blanket CS. Deep Freeze onto Seedu, Tabadar down to 150k, is just casting damage right now, but does decide to line of sight with that Healing Tide down. Gonna keep him up. Yips put into a full Fear though, Seedu does get a good spell on that though. But that was the Frozen Orb from Faku, so looks like he's not gonna have too much damage for a little while, so they're gonna want to get some pressure here. Faku did have his own use up there as well, but Tabadar just being forced back over and over, this team just getting so much pressure out onto Team EG.
Yeah, this is a game where Team EG needs to take a win before the draw mark, so... And Talbar gets locked out on Lightning Bolt, so he's not going to be able to do any pressure right now. Manchester actually managed to cast there. That's the crosses I'm looking for. A Hex into Faku and a full clone into Phenonum. And look at Kallak at the same time. He has to drop healing threat. He has to do Shamrage. He wasn't 30% HP. He has to just play defensive and heal himself. He gets Thunderstorm into an awkward position as well, so that's what he needs to do. And there's a DR ship into Cedio. I think SPD the first one, so that good job by Cedio as well.
That was a deep freeze onto Yips as well there, so they didn't really get too much damage. That's healing stream comes down from Talbadar though. And it's Yips and Talbadar both in a lot of trouble. Frozen Orb comes out for Faku. Talbadar not in a great spot right now. Down to half health, in a lot of trouble. Apparat, Yips does put a Disorient onto Faku, shutting down that damage. Gonna let them kite to the pillar. Thunderstorm comes out from Talbadar. Yips in taking a lot of damage, but he is connecting onto Kallak right now, who's stuck behind the pillar on his own. Does get life grip down, but Yips is going to follow him straight out there. Yips still in the open, quite vulnerable. Talbadar looks like he is going to be the target as Faku's just putting lance after lance into him. Full fear on Cedu here though. The Hex onto Faku is not being dispelled just yet. It does come out, get the dispel now, but he is going to be casting Polymorph. Looks like Cedu's in a full sheep now. Talbadar's in a full deep freeze. He's in a lot of trouble. Guardian Spirit onto him. So he's actually going to be fine right now. They're not really under a lot of pressure, but might have been a little bit of a waste of Guardian Spirit, to be honest, because Yips did Tranquility as well, but Talbadar's put into a half fear now.
Yeah, and that was kind of overlapped. He should have just shrink it and that would have been enough, but maybe it's going to hurt him back then. It doesn't look like too much, so he has Life Support available for him now, and so that's going to be fine. Talbot has his trinket available as well. The Faku just looking for those sheeps here, and he's going to get the extra Skull Bash on that one, it seems like. Maybe manage to fake it. Here comes the orb here on Talbadar. Deep freeze into Cedu, force the CC. Can he get anything off that? But Talbadar has to shamage really early. Good job by him. There's no CC on Cedu out of that deep freeze, which is kind of poor, because if they had any more CC, they would be able to force something more, to be honest.
Well, the Nature's Guardian did come out from
Look
Talbadar
at Faku,
you
just spiking out to 30%.
Yeah, Yips and Cedu really burst. Now Faku with the full clone on Phenomenon. Phenomenon, if there's any follow-up on CC on him, could be in trouble. Has got the Fear Ward and Aura Mastery available right now, though. So no CC just yet. Fear Ward dispelled by Cedu, though. So he's looking to maybe chase for a Fear soon, but doesn't want to push it into the open. Full Hex onto Kallak right now, but Faku dispels it. Faku down to about 60%, getting picked up by Aphra. Phenomenon, who does fake the CS, but does get put into a Disorient just after that. Browning was down, Penance coming out, and Barrier from him as well. So Kallak in a lot of trouble right now as they swapped over the damage. Faku was forced to Will of Forsaken there as well, get sheared on Polymorph, so Yips able to push him right now. Cedu trying to keep up and just keep him topped. Put Blanket on Cedu though, this could be the start of it. Yips in a bit of trouble, does use his Survival Instinct, he's got a shield up, he's going to be fine for the time being, so he's just looking to pull back with this. I'd have liked to see him go a bit more aggressive, but they did force Faku in, but he had the ult time up, so he just supported back and was fine.
Yeah, they also forced the Survival Instinct of Yips, which is his shield wall, which is one of his bigger cooldowns, so he has used shield wall, and the only CD he has actually left now, Yips, is actually Dispersion. Cedu is about to get Trinket back, so he might be fine for now, but I mean, if they actually have a huge change into Cedu, even though he trinkets, maybe Yips is still gonna go down, maybe. He has his Dispersion available, so here comes the defreeze into Yips here, and Blacks is into Cedu. Are they gonna force the Dispersion here? Barskin is up, but no more CC into Cedu. I think they need to have the clone as well. Now, I mean, something, and this comes the sheep here, to capture them, and he might be able to force the dispersion here. He's on 20% HP. Barskin is running out here. He has ended up himself, and he's gonna dispersion before, so he was just about to go down. Good choice by him, and this was the last defensive CD of Yips. He used Barskin as well together with that dispersion as well, right before he had to use dispersion. So really good job by Nathan from the beach here, forcing everything, and I think the next swap is just gonna be game here.
This is Faku's on use though, and the burst coming out from Kallak, he is getting an Elemental Blast off. So interestingly, he is actually running Elemental Blast, but Yips gets a Disorient, kicks him off that. No CC on Phenomenon right now, he has just got Spirit Shells on his teammates. So Talbadar in a little bit of trouble, did get a Wind Shear on him, Grounding coming down, Hex onto Talbadar, it does break instantly, does Thunderstorm away, Capacitor down, hits Cedu, with a Fear on Cedu as well. Talb and Yips both caught into that. Talb does Sham Rage there. Cedu put into a full sheep and a half fear on top from Siphene though. So no more fear DRs for Cedu now. It has got that full sheep sat on him right now though.
And he gets three sheep like that.
Talbadar getting a huge amount of damage onto Faku as Yips is forced to come play defensive and just pull back.
Yeah, and Cedu actually got reshipped though. That overlap kind of kind of ruined their swap onto Yips, and which was kind of poor, because if they actually, unfortunate, if they actually had that CC lined up perfectly, I think they would be able to force either kill up Yips or force Trinket on Cedu or Lightstorm.
Talbadar and Yips there though. Cedu does just side spell Yips. Talbadar sits there, gets fed back. Does go to Faku, goes to Polymorph in, but does get sheared on that. Yips in a little bit of trouble. Does get a Thunderstorm onto Faku though. Looks like Kallax is going to be put into a Hex. Baku goes for a polymorph, cancels it to dispel the hex, while Phenomenon sat at full coin. Kallak in a bit of trouble though, down to about 30%, but no CC to follow up on Phenomenon, so looks like it's gonna be fine. Fear onto Yips and Talbadar again though. Again, CD prioritizing Yips on that dispel. Talbadar gonna have to sit there. Talbadar into a blanket CS right now though. Spirit Shells and PS used by Phenomenon right now. Cedu in a full sheep, Yips is going to be the target, Yips is going to be in a bit of trouble, does run away as soon as he sees that sheep come out, gets behind the, gets off the edge and just heals. Talbadar in a little bit of trouble though, does get knocked off to the opposite side. Yips now in a huge amount of trouble, down to about 20%. Cedu in a half sheep, is going to have to heal himself, is going to have Talbadar healing him as well. Looks like he might be fine through this because he did bark skin. Fear used there, not on Cedu though, so Cedu's pushing him right now. Looks like he's going to get the fear, gets the full fear onto Phenomenon, forces his trinket, and Cedu was put into a sheep there. Clone on Phenomenon's trinket, so Kallak in a huge amount of trouble, but Faku landed the sheep on Cedu, but it clipped the DR and hit a 2 second sheep, so Cedu going to be fine for a while. Hex onto Faku there.
Yeah, and Kallak took so much pressure there, but he actually managed to actually be a phenomenon. Actually, was able to keep him up somehow, some way. Yips taking some serious pressure here. Cedu is doing a good job staying max range on the other pillar here, but Yips is still too far away. And Cedu is actually running with the spectral in the stealth here, running in, but Yips is just dropping really low, relatively low, with triple fear from Cedu. Nice job by him. Can he do anything with this? Kallak drops to 10% HP. He's Sham Rage. There comes a life swap on from Phenomenon, barely on 2% HP on Kallak. Such a good fear by Cedu. Game breaking, what a good job by him, but still, that is fair into Yips, and he's just forwarded to a real bad position, and he has used Bear Wall and Ursoc, and so he's got lives up on Cedu as well, and both teams making major plays here. So much damage coming from both teams, and that's gonna be forced to spur lives up on both teams, which is the biggest CD of both teams. And I think actually Kallak used his form there, Eskinens, to do extra DPS, do his maximum damage here.
And they are sending out to Cedu. They're sending on Cedu right now though. Sorry, Talbadar, and he's in a lot of trouble. Does Healing Tide, standing in the open with Sham Rage, can't see him himself. Looks like he's going to be okay for the time being. He's going to turn around, start casting damage onto Kala. Yips gets knocked down into quite a bad spot though. Looks like he's going to get back up into Cedu's line of sight before anything too bad happens. Phenomenon put into a full clone right now, while Cedu was put into a sheep, but I think he trinketed that actually. He's pushing in right now. Gonna be able to fear off that. Lands the fear. Disorient on top as well. The fear was broken there. I'm not sure what broke that. But a full ring onto Yips right now. Yips unable to finish this. And Cedu blew his trinket there. He's put into a blanket right now. So if the FMP can follow up on this, they're definitely gonna get a dispersion by Yips though.
Yeah, and that was dispersion, so they have actually nothing left. Cedu went for the offensive trinket there on and trying to get a triple fair again on Phenomenon. I mean, he trinketed offensively, but it just broke instantly, somehow, some way. But again, Cedu, that must just cost them the game, because they had to use trinket there, and they had to use dispersion, just because they actually went to play offensive. I mean, he's
Yips in a lot of trouble right now. He has Guardian Spear on himself. He's just going to push out. Cedu getting a chastise into a fear on Phenomenon. Does Will have Forsaken that, I believe. So he's going to be fine for the time being. Looks like Kallak still the main target there. Cyclone onto Apra and Fake You at the same time. Forces Phenomenon's trinket right now. And
Kallak dropping so low. Catches the PS
as well. Full sheep on Cedu though. So let's see what they can do with this. No pressure onto Yips or Talbadar right now. Yips, Cedu actually walks into a ring with that sheep as well, so going to be on full DR for that, just a 2 second sheep available. Full sheep onto Cedu though, with a blanket onto Talbadar, a blanket on Cedu, deep on Yips. Yips in a lot of trouble, does blow his bark skin there. He's going to look to try and get to the pillar with Cedu. Looks like he's going to Heart of the Wild NS hit himself, and he's going to top himself.
Yeah, and there's a chance that he's in Phenomenon into a full fear here. Do they have Tremor available for that? He's going to have to Sham Rage at least, and there's a trinket from Phenomenon there, and might just die. Talbadar has been popping his Eskinus here, the full clone into Phenomenon as well. They might be able to actually pin him off Kallak here, as he doesn't have Sham Rage available.
There's any follow-up CC onto Phenomenon, they will get this kill, but doesn't look like that's available. Yip's chasing him for a Disorient there, but unable to gets the Disorient now, a little bit late, but great kiting there by Phenomenon. But
he's just going to go down.
Faku did try to get sheeps out there, but interestingly, at the end, he chose to sheep Cedu, which meant that Cedu was in CC, but he hadn't bothered to CC the Elemental Shaman who's doing the damage, so...
Yeah, and that's going to be real unfortunate for Nafig from the beach, as it was actually 30 seconds left for a draw there, so... Yeah, to be honest, this is so even, it's unreal. So we're just gonna see what's gonna happen in the third game. I have no predictions of who's gonna take this, but I feel like Nafig from the beach capitalized on the EG's mistake by EG's Cedu's mistake. But oh, I did join instantly, but figure should be fine.
If you log out, you can.
Hmm.
If you log out, you can log back in and fix it. You can log back in. Alright, okay.
So it should be fine. To be honest, I think kind of the reason why Nafig from the Beach had so huge momentum was because CD ran in often and tried to get fair, and one of the times when he ran in to get a fair, they had Tremor available, Kalak had Tremor available, and there wasn't a cross CC on him. So maybe it was a miscommunication, but he trinketed a sheep to get that fair, and they didn't really do anything with it. And at the same time, he had to use Trinket, and Yips had to use his dispersion because CD ran in and got CC'd. So that was kind of bad for them, and it really turned back. Gonna give someone upper leader.
So interestingly, they did choose Tolvir this time, which is probably the most like Magrand arena there is. I mean, there's the pillar on the opposite side, so they've got the two kind of stair bits. And, I'm thinking the wrong map. Sorry, yeah, this is the three pillars. So it looks like they, the FMP really think they're going to do well on that kind of map, whereas Sidhu, Taubadar, and Yips obviously thought they were going to do better off with the knockdowns that they can get on the blades on Dalaran, even though that did hurt them a little bit. Oh, we're restarting this game.
That's my bad, guys. Misclicked. Join instantly. So, just gonna not do the same again. It's gonna be a little bit delay, sorry about that.
So with this map, who do you think is going to take it? Because I'm going to have to give this to EG, because I think they played a lot better in the second game. They were a lot more... They didn't overlap as many cooldowns, which I thought was really what let them down in the first game.
Well, I think it's going to matter on what they do, because it depends. If CDU goes in and tries to get CC, and count it back if it backfires, if actually Nafig from the Beast capitalizes on that each time, well, each time CDU goes in to get CC, they CC him before he gets CC. I think they can win like that. But
I'll be surprised if we see CDU going in for CC without using Spectral Guys first. Obviously, this is a much larger map than Dalaran. And so, I think
Still fake, you can bring Frost around the map, you know?
Yeah, but I mean, if CDU goes in without Spectral Guys, they're just going to see it coming a mile away. So
yeah, they're still going to be able to see it, like... Trust me, good man, yeah. You see it instantly. And they're gonna be able to ring Frost. They're gonna even, like, I even pet Nova, for example, Priest, to try to do it. You can easily pet Nova or Roost him before, and then they all can, like, for example, get a fair on a pet or a mage or something like that, which isn't too huge as getting CC on the healer. So, if they actually, stop CDU getting those fairs and CC him while he's in that awkward position, and just burst someone down while he's CC'd, that's the way Nafig from the Beach can do it. But they also can get a lot of CC, of course, on CDU. So, I think Nafig from the Beach should be able to take this one, as they also have the map advantage.
I think they may need to be... I think that early shame is re-logging, so I'm not sure if we need to restart the game or not, we'll have to see. Yeah, I'm going to have to restart this when we can. But I think a lot of this matchup is going to come down to how Yips plays as well and how he uses Treants. Because with the Treant stuns, they're obviously just... they can interrupt casts just all the time. And so they're really frustrating to play against. And so if he can shut down Burst at the right times or get stuns when they're trying to deep freeze him, then I really think that he's going to shut down too much of that pressure during that Burst. And then EG are just going to be able to turn it around when they go for CC. Because they don't really... Yeah, FAQ's team don't really have anything like that that they can stop with preemptively. They have to kind of do it reactively. Yes, we can join now. Okay, so that is going to be everyone killed off, so we are going to get this countdown started in just a moment, and then we're going to have this final game with this matchup underway, and then they will be going into a second pick and ban phase.
So, we're going to see who's going to be able to take this first best of three series, guys. It's going to be interesting. Countdown has begun. 20 seconds from now, we're going to be able to go into the game and see who's going to take this. EG or Nafig from the beach. Give some shout-outs in the chat, guys, to the team you want to win. Is it going to be EG taking the first best of three, or is it going to be Nafig from the beach? We're going to be seeing that real soon, guys.
Okay, so Fake, you're going to be going to Invis straight away. Both LA Shamans getting love, Flame Sharks and Lava Burst out to start with. Psy Fiend out straight away from Phenomenon, though, so they are just going to run away from that and avoid that. Seedu going in stealth, though, does get a full fear onto Phenomenon straight away. That forces a really early Tremor Totem. Let's see if they can make use of that. But Yips looks like he's going to be the main target. Seedu, Tawadar put into a Nova, looks like he's going to take a lot of damage as he was out in the open for a second. Healing Stream comes out from him. Yips on his own forces a Mindbender solo, so they're just going to kite that out, and not like that give too much mana back, really. But Phenomenon looks like he might want to push in for Fear soon, but decides not to as Fake you gets bent into a full clone. And Kallak has actually used his Trinket already, so EG doing a great job forcing these early cooldowns. Seedu moving in the Spectral guys. Looks like they know it's coming, but Seedu does get the Fear. Looks like it's going to land it onto Phenomenon. Phenomenon does Will of the Forsaken that. Even though it's in Spectral guys, great job by Seedu there. Yip still looking to be the target, as is Kallak. Yips into full deep with Seedu in a blanket. Barkskin used Healing Stream down from Tawadar as well. This could be a lot of pressure. Full Sheep on Seedu, but does death that, so he's going to be just fine.
Yeah, and they've been doing a good job actually getting the CC into Phenomenon. And right now it's a full clone, and Fakeyu's taking some serious pressure. They're actually going to clone Fakeyu here, as they want to get some more CC. But look at Kallak, he's just going to go down! Wow!
EG just pulling that out of nowhere and absolutely destroying them.
Oh my god! Are you for real? Wow, that damage was just fucking unreal. Like, he went in Escadence and he just globaled him. He actually just killed him. That was the most craziest thing.
Those Ascendance cooldowns from Ellie Shamans are just terrifying. And that time, EG just chose, well, Tabadar in particular, chose his time perfectly. And no CC to stop him, no CS available. And just absolutely dominated Nafig from the beach there.